ordinary entry-level welding is over. Defy convention. Go rogue. Fine-tuning the MIG arc. The following advice works for any MIG welder operating in a standard short-circuit transfer mode. Start by setting wire feed speed, which controls amperage and penetration. Use an amperage that matches the wire diameter, shielding gas, and material thickness. You can also calculate the approximate wire feed speed using the general guidelines and formula shown here. Voltage controls height and width of weld bead, as well as the wire melt-off rate. A finely tuned MIG arc has a sizzling bacon sound that signifies a proper balance of wire feed speed and voltage. A harsh sound with a lot of pops usually means that the wire is melting faster than it's coming out of the gun. To solve the problem, decrease voltage or increase wire feed speed. If the wire stubs into the base metal, there's not enough voltage to melt the wire. Solve the problem by increasing voltage or reducing wire feed speed. Good MIG mechanics. To properly fine-tune the arc, you need good MIG gun mechanics. First, use the proper contact tip to work distance. For short circuit MIG, this will be about 1/4 inch to 3/8 inch. Second, keep the wire on the leading edge of the weld puddle. And third, use a gun angle of between 5 and 15 degrees. If you struggle with setting weld parameters, the real culprit might be poor technique. Weld bead appearance can also offer clues to adjusting values. These examples provide some basic guidance.